So the last time I played here, I think it might have been almost 10 years ago, maybe less. I don't know. But my I have two kids, and they were probably toddlers then, and now they're teenagers, and they're over at Paul's house. And
yes, you have to be close to
the mic. He by my request, made the internet mysteriously disappear. So they have like three channels on a TV and books. And there's no cell service. It's great. They're fun. I feel like tonight is so beautiful. I wish I had a song that could meet the beauty of this. Like, I wish I had a song that just, well, it just spoke this, like the outdoors beautiful. So I have to write that, but I haven't. So I'm going to start with a song that was inspired by a trip to Cape Cod when I couldn't get over the bridge for a short time. And we'll see. Not for the usual reasons, though. Trucks filled a whole load of cranberries across the Sagamore Bridge. No one died, thank the good fairies. Now I got some in my fridge. Commuters waited in traffic, got out of their cars to see. The ambulance threw, cheered the cleanup crew, and put it out on their Twitter feed.
About all the pushing,
standing in line. But like my friends say, you gotta do it anyway. Just gets harder when you ask why. And I'm tired from all the wait. I'm tired of being strong.
Placement of the free throw line. He's got an old chair.
snowshoes, warped wooden skis, hardcover books, pages all turned round. My dad has a reason for everything he keeps around.
You don't see a soul for the 5 days you're there. It's on a cove where you can swim if you're really crazy. But it's over Columbus Day weekend, that's why I wouldn't be able to swim then. But anyway, I wanted to let you know about that. You can ask me about it or go to my website if you're interested, because we have room in it for anybody who's a writer of any kind. We take songwriters, but sometimes people are just trying to write something from beginners to pro, so anyway. all, I believe all of us have something to say and can learn to write if you have, you know, if you have a passion. So even I'll bring songs to the circle at the songwriter retreat. You know, part of what happens is just being around people, you kind of get more energy to write. And you, then you bring it to the circle and people give you feedback. And so I had this song I was working on, a play for you, and I was stuck on a couple of lines, and I sent it to my friend Fred in Nashville, who's great, and he rewrote the lines, and then I brought it to the circle, and everybody was like, it doesn't seem like that's really what you want to say. So I went back in my room and just, boom, wrote the lines, saying what I really wanted to say, and I decided, I brought it back, and it seems to really work, but it's like, it's the first time I ever used the word sexy in a song. So you never know what'll happen if you go to this retreat. Crazy things. Right. So that was just a lot of tuning. That's the most tuning I'll do all night, so. Is that MJ back there? Oh, no, never mind. So I have a song that I've written for my girls, and I really, you know, I think it's a really hard time to be a teenager. So much is out there on the internet, and so many crazy ideas about what a girl and a woman is supposed to be. So, it's a time when it's okay to make mistakes. So, this is for them. And,
you are fragile, you are tough. Army boots and China cups. You still think you're not enough for someone else. You fall in and you fall out, doing things that you're not proud of. Still trying to learn how to love yourself. You are fact and you are fiction, searching for a piece that's missing. Still thinking that you need some fixing up. You are joyful and you're jealous. In the rain without umbrellas. Searching for someone to tell you you are loved.
Goes on. I go.
making more songs, and then I understand there's an intermission featuring bats and Waterman. This is a crazy fun place.
Look at that
in Carnegie Hall. No, I don't get that. I did play one song in Carnegie Hall once. Thank you very much. I mean, there was an audience and everything. And just like comes a tourist and you've got my guitar. But I do love this. This is a family. I don't know, being from Maine and stuff, it's just like, this is real. This is real people, you know? I spend time in Los Angeles and other places and it's not real. but I've really been inspired by the Olympics.
Yeah.
Anybody been watching the Olympics?
Yep.
Yeah. You know, there's these ads featuring, you know, I love the women's gymnastics, and there are these ads that, you know, really kind of encourage you to dream that even you could be an Olympic gymnast. And so I've been thinking about it. Because I saw there was one woman who was 41 from Romania. I'm 51. But then Diana Nyad, well, she was 62 when she swam from Cuba to Key West. No, not Key West, the Keys.
Key West.
And that's very impressive. I just watched the movie about it. So all the way here, I was thinking about writing a song to really try to make this vision real, you know? Like, start with summer salts every day, and up to the vault, you know? Back bend on the balance beam. You know, if I do it every day for 4 years, and then I get out of the car and my hips hurt and my knees hurt. That first, I think. I don't know, we got here, my daughter's pretty much convinced me that it wasn't going to happen. So we turned to the internet, Paul looked up the oldest Olympian, and it turns out there's like a 62-year-old equestrian in the Olympics, so there's hope. I do it every day.
The oldest is 72.
70.
Yeah. 1920.
Oh, in 1920. What a shooter. Do they still have shooting?
Yeah.
Now why isn't that on the TV?
Yeah, right.
It's what? It's held in Milwaukee?
No.
Oh, I'm sorry. Anyway.
To our kids, from the day when they climb from their cribs, try to teach them well, show them that they're loved, but in the end, but
I just saw all of a sudden thought, Missy, you don't want to come up and sing, do you?
No.
You don't?
No.
Just check. Just on the chorus. We are passing this world to from the day they come from the cribs. Try to teach them well, show them that they're loved, but in the end all we can do is hope our best is good enough. Cause they'll witness how this life can be so beautiful and cruel. We can't shelter them forever, but if we show them all the tools, they might world in a little better shape than me and you.
MJ, you probably don't want to come up here.
Yeah, you don't know how to ask that.
We are only passing through. Passing through. Passing through. We are only passing through. Passing through. This whole world is our neighborhood, and there's nowhere left to run to stay above the fray. We better learn to get along, not just to get our way, not only for each other, but our children's children too. We are only passing through.
going to walk out, and maybe if I was lucky, you'd bring me back up. And I just didn't want you to have to go through that. Singing along and everything. I cannot wait to hear Bill Staines. I'm a big fan, and I'm really excited that he's here tonight. So we have that to look forward to. This is a song where the chorus says good night, good night, and then a couple other things, and then good night. No, it's not. Good night. All I have is a song to sing for you. When the night grows cold and the wind blows through, wishing there was something more that I could do. For tonight, dear, I'll sing for you. Good night, good night.
That's the sing along, right?
Good night.
Shining through the darkness of the blackest night. they came. For some it is a story filled with emptiness and pain. Yet with rising winds and chorus, we search for steady ground. There is only that before us. There can be no turning round. We are crossing the water.
Come
It's a song for me, a sweet violin song. I played that song one time in Albany, New York, and this fellow came up to me and he said, "Well, I guess you just went and got 10 copies of Sports Illustrated today, didn't you?" And I thought, "Well, no." So it was a big article about rodeo riding, and they used most of your song, "Sweet Wyoming Home." And then I thought, "Well, that's pretty cool, you know. I could be the only songwriter that's had a song published in Sports Illustrated." Take it where you can get it. So I've been working on Architectural Digest since then. Well, after my second songs, my sets begin to sound like travelogues, because I do a lot of traveling around. I'll tell you this short story. I was doing a little festival south of Minneapolis 5 years ago, something like that. And I flew from Logan Airport to Minneapolis, and there was a change in planes in Cleveland. And I got to Cleveland around noon. And I had a little bit of time in the airport, so I walked into one of those bar restaurant things they have at the airport, you know, to get something to eat. And there was a fellow sitting next to me at the bar. He was probably in his 80s, I guess, and we struck up this small talk conversation. And the waitress came over, and she said, "What would you like to eat?" I said, "I'll have a crab melt." "Okay, crab melt." Off she goes. So this guy turns to me and he says, "So where are you going?" And I thought, he said, "What are you having?" And I looked at him and I said, "Crab melt." And he got this funny look on his face. "Crab melt? Must be someplace in Maine." And I thought, he said, "You must be from someplace in Maine." And I said, "Nope, just across the river." Stupider and stupider. This is kind of a southern song. It's one called Savannah. Savannah sang a song for me, a lazy tune in a live oak tree. In my heart, you will always be a sunny southern girl. Watch a river slip away. Come follow me, it seems to say. Like Mercer's moon on a magic day, we'll be off to see the world. I can hear your Sunday steeple bells ring out the tunes that I know so well. Hear the voices rise, the praises swell, beneath the neon Jesus says. Beneath your blue and heaven skies, the seabirds call, the time slips by. The shrimp boats leave on the morning tide and roll out across the waves. I was told that sometime way back when, your beauty bold and your pride unbent, as a present to a president of the war around his room. Savannah sang a song for me, had a lazy tune in a live oak tree. You're now, but you'll always be that sunny summer. Beneath silver moss the lovers meet, down flowered paths by the jasmine sweet, they step out across the square. Magnolia shade, the old cafe, on the burning sun at the height of day. I've been gone so long, now I'm on my way to Savannah Fair. I was told that sometime way back when, when your beauty bone and your pride undone, as a present to a president of the war around his room. Savannah sang a song for me, had a lazy tune in the live oak tree. You're now, but you'll always be that sunny southern girl. Now, but you'll always be that sunny southern girl.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Well, this is one called Piney River Girl. Piney River is a little town about halfway between Charlottesville and Amherst, Virginia. Nestled down in the Blue Ridge, not far from Rockfish Gap, Walton's country. Heard the sound of a redbird singing and the call of a whippoorwill as the sun poured over the eastern bridges and on the morning hills. I heard the sound of an old blue hound as it wakened to the day. Shook off all of its hound dog dreams and wandered on its way.
Frolic fields of golden grass,
takes the icy winter's blast to lie by home fires burning. The dogs wander off alone. Old dogs know the wind at home. The sight is set, the berry low.
I'll get
get through the cold before it's dark. Got to stay dressed, call me Pony Express, and my rig is a wild, wild car. Got to stay dressed, call me Pony Express, and my rig is a wild, wild car. It's how it was in the semi. Windy whistled away in my ears. Some babies go to sleep to a lullaby. Yes, and mine was the sound of the gear. In Boise, Idaho for years, and I know that guy. He even told me his name, which I immediately forgot. Well, I don't know how I got this, but for a few years, like 4 or 5 years, back in the late 1800s, back in the late 80s, early 90s, I was doing some of the music for the video productions for Burlington Northern Railroad. They used to have a quarterly video they called Being on Camera. And it wasn't so much industry stuff as it was human interest stories and a lot of railroad history, which was pretty cool. And at one point they phoned me up from Fort Worth, where they had this production facility. In fact, you can see some of these videos on YouTube. I don't know where they came from. But anyway, they called me up from Fort Worth and they said, you know, there's a program making its way around the country called Parent to Parent. And it's a program where parents get together and talk to each other about getting their kids off of drugs and keeping their kids off of drugs. And Burlington was about to adopt this program into their system as an in-house resource for their employees. So they phoned me up and said, we're going to do a video presentation of this program. And what we really need for the video is a theme song. And I thought, what? And I said, well, you know, you're a parent. Just write a song about how parents feel about their kids or should feel about their kids. And I thought, just call tomorrow. But nevertheless, child of mine, you are the wildest wind and the dearest dream I will ever know. Love's lasting love shines out from deep within this father's heart as I watch you grow. Child of mine, you are the break of dawn and the brightest star I will ever know. Love's lasting light, I'm shining on and on from this mother's heart as I watch you grow. There's a road, and that road is all your own. We are here, you need not walk alone. Face my fear, each coming new one is the way. Lift your wings, child of mine. You are the sweetest song and the greatest gift I'll ever know. So let it grow. and it will thrive on love, for it is love that sees us through. You have the hands that will open up the doors. You have the voice. This world is waiting for you. You are my own, but you are so much more. You are tomorrow on the wing. Child,
I'll do that part.
You have the hands that will open up the doors. You have the voice. This world is waiting for you. You are my own, but you are so much more. You are tomorrow on the wing.
You know, you do a song for a long time, and sometimes there are these events that attach themselves to the songs, you know. I remember when my son was in high school many years ago, I was passing by his room at home one day, and his door was open, and he was sitting there with his back to me, playing this piece of music that he'd written on the keyboards, and it was like this slow, lyrical piece, almost like an air type of thing, and I stopped to listen to him play, and it was like one of these poignant moments when you're listening to your kid play music. And then he did this teenage thing, and he got the sense that somebody was watching him. I'll never forget. Turns around, looks me straight in the face and goes, "What?" It's like, what do you say, you know? I just came by to pick up the rent. Well, back in the late 70s, 1970s, I used to read a lot of Jack Kerouac and Thomas Wolfe, as some of us did. And so this next song is kind of a cross between Kerouac, Wolfe, and Staines, if you can put that trio together. It's called Dharma Bums, which is the title of one of Kerouac's works. And if you can pick up on the chorus, help me with it. I knew a time when we danced with dreams and we looked for love in the quiet streets, and the crazy world just passed us by with a wistful way. It was on the fly. We were a different breed. We knew Dharma bums. We caught the endless trains out towards the setting sun. And when the morning came, we lifted up the sky. We found a fiery flame. Thought we'd never die. We did the drunkard's dance. We played the poet's hymn. We searched for answers then and found them deep within. And all our words were wild, and all our stories young. We were the restless child, adrift beneath the sun. We were a different breed. We knew the dharmas. We caught the endless trains out towards the setting sun. And when the morning came, we lifted up the sky. We found the fiery flame. Turns to fall, sometimes I drift away, and I hear the call. Time and time has gone by, the fond and fairest friends, they still before me fly. And I remember when we were a different breed. We knew the dark roads, we caught the endless trains
was obviously do a lot of songs about traveling around, and I get back to New England where I'm from, and occasionally somebody will come up to me and go, "Why don't you ever write a song about New England? Why don't you ever write a song about fishing?" Well, before one of my tours, I took my little chair and crossword puzzle and went down to the shore, as I'm apt to do before I go out on the tour, one warm morning. And I was sitting there doing the puzzle, and I looked up and there were all these fishing boats going out for the day. So I never did finish the puzzle that day. I just wrote the song in the margin of the puzzle. But it has a nice melody to it. And what I'd like to do is, I'll go through the melody once, and if you'll join me second time around, it sort of it lends itself to the personality of the song, okay? And then we'll get into the song. It's called "To Open Water." It goes like this. one more for you, and then we're going to bring Catie up and do a couple together here. This is a song that has followed me for lots and lots of years. Hard to believe this song was written 41 years ago. I was 4.
Thank you.
show gets too sleek for you, just let me know. Why not? Yeah. You want to grab a chair?
Trace left behind.
got one more for you, and so drive safely, everybody. Fasten your seatbelts. I saw a bumper sticker that said, fasten your seatbelts, and makes it harder for the aliens to suck you out of your car. My favorite one nowadays is, am I driving too close in front of you? This is an old hymn. It's very simple, and it's beautiful when you hear a lot of people sing the harmonies on it. It comes from about the 1880s. I can't remember who wrote it. But it's always been one of my favorites. Up and away, like the dew in the morning, soaring from earth to our home in the summer. Thus would we be from the earth and its turning. For what we have done. Only remember, oh, only remember, only remember for what we have done. Only remember, only remember, only remember for what we have done. Only that in life we have spoken, only the seeds that on earth we have sown, these shall pass onward.